Good morning, students. So today we are going to start our fifth chapter, that is plant, right? As we know that in plant there are main parts, root and shoot part, and on shoot we see leaves, stem, flowers, fruits, seeds, right? So in these parts, flower is the most important part of plant, right? As all of you have seen many flowers, you have seen rose, china rose, sunflower, marigold, pansy. You see all many colorful flowers in your daily life, right? So today in this chapter we are going to study about pollination and flowers, right? So first of all we are going to study the structure of flower. As I have taken this china rose to show the parts of a flower, right? First of all, as we see that this is the branch on which flower is grown, right? This is the, from here, the part from where this flower grows, this is called peduncle. इसको हम क्या कहते हैं, this is called peduncle, right? This peduncle, you can see here the swollen part. You can see the green colored leaves of this part. This part is called thalamus. This swollen part is called thalamus. This whole part is thalamus. The green colored leaves of flower, इनको हम क्या कहते हैं, the green colored leaves of flower, they are called calyx. And the beautiful colorful flowers, these leaves, floral leaves, these are called corolla, right? And here when we are talking about the parts of flower, this is peduncle, thalamus, right? Its sepals, green colored sepals, these are green colored sepals of flower, right? This is thalamus part which joins the complete flower, which covers complete flower. It protects floral bud also, right? Now here I will separate its petals. These are the colorful leaves of flower. They are known as petal, right? And after removing petal, here is ovary. This is the ovary, right? This is the ovary of flower, right? It contains ovule, and this is the female part of flower. This is the female part of flower. Here you can see these structures which contain some yellow balls. This is called stamen. This is called stamen. So now parts of flower, right? As we know that, as already I told you that flower has four main parts. One is calyx. Calyx is the outermost pearl. It contains green leaves which are known as sepals. See this part. This part is sepal, right? In the thalamus, this swollen part, pedicel, which is swollen, it contains thalamus, and in thalamus there are green leaves with the first pearl of the flower. It is called sepal or it is called calyx, right? The second one is corolla. Corolla, that means this part, the colorful leaves of flower. These colorful leaves of flower, they attract insects for pollination. They contain nectar. As many insects, they feed on the nectar which is provided by flowers. So insects, they get attracted towards the bright colors of this corolla. Corolla is also known as petal. Corolla ko hum petal bhi bolte hain. After petals, the third part is gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female part of flower. It is also known as कार्बन। अगर हम इसके अलग से स्ट्रक्चर देखें तो द पार्ट ऑफ फीमेल पार्ट ऑफ फ्लावर इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ राउंड पोर्शन एट द बॉटम, दिस इज कॉल्ड ओवरी। दिस इज कॉल्ड ओवरी। ओवरी कंटेन्स ओव्यूल विच फर्दर ग्रोज इनटू सीड फॉर फ्यूचर प्लांट, राइट? एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड ओव्यूल। दिस लॉन्ग ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इट इज कॉल्ड स्पाइन। एंड द अटैचिंग प्लेटफॉर्म एट द टॉप ऑफ पिस्टल इट इज नोन एज स्टिग्मा। So all these constitute female part of flower, that is pistil or gynoecium, right? Ovary, when it develops, it ripens, it forms fruit. Ovule ripens to form seed, right? And seed contains embryo for future plant, right? Now fourth part is androecium, which is known as stamen. Stamen is the main part of flower, and when we see its structure, it contains a pollen sac and a long filament. This is known as filament, and this upper portion is called anther. Anther contains pollen sacs. Pollen sacs. In pollen sac, pollen grains are produced, right? In anther, pollen sacs are there. अगर हम anther की structure देखें, तो here pollen grains in anther are produced when pollen grains are attached to the part to the feet of insects. They are transferred from one flower to another flower by means of wind, by means of insects, by means of water. This is called pollination, right? So pollen grains, they are the main part, male reproductive part. Fertilization, ovary ripens to form fruit and ovule ripens to form seed, right? Now pollen grains contain male reproductive cells . Ovary contains female reproductive cells, that is egg, and egg is contained in ovule, which further ripens to form seed, and seed contains embryo, and embryo develops into new plant after germination, right? This is how flower helps to produce formation of new plant, right? Now next we will study about flowers. Flowers are of two types, monosexual and bisexual flowers. Monosexual flowers are the flowers which contain only one either male part or female part. That is, the flowers either it will contain stamen or it will contain gynoecium, right, or pistil. The part which contain only pistil, it is called female flower, right? Monosexual, mono means only single reproductive part, right? Like watermelon. Watermelon is monosexual flower, right? Some flowers, they contain both reproductive parts, that is stamen or androecium, as well as pistil, male reproductive part and female reproductive part. Such type of flowers are called bisexual flowers. For example, China rose, as already we had seen in the beginning of this chapter, red color ka flower jo humne dekha tha, China rose, right? That is bisexual flower. It contains both male reproductive part as well as female reproductive part. Next, pollination. Pollination is the process of transfer of pollen grain of one flower to the stigma of, that is to the female reproductive part of another flower or of the same flower. It is called pollination, right? Pollination means transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another flower. In pollination, we have two types of pollination. One is self-pollination. In self-pollination, pollen grains are transferred by their self means. That means from the same flower, from same plant, the pollen grains, they are transferred from one flower to another flower or from the male part to female part of the same plant. This is called self-pollination. In cross-pollination, we require some carriers, some agents which can carry pollen grains from one part of, from one flower to another flower, and plants, they are quite far away from each other, right? In this case, we require some carriers, some agents, and agents can be wind, they can be water or insects. As you have seen, flowers are of bright color and many insects, they get attracted towards flowers. They eat nectar from the flowers, and when they sit on the flowers, the pollen grains, they stick to their feet, and when these insects, they fly to another flower, they leave these pollen grains over the stigma of another flower. And in this way, pollination take place, and after pollination, fertilization take place and new plants are developed. Such type of pollination in which insects, wind, water, they carry pollen grains from one flower to another flower of different plants, such type of pollination is called cross-pollination. Cross-pollination takes place in rose, in China rose, then in corn, wheat, right? These are the examples in which cross-pollination takes place.